Universidad de Guadalajara y el Centro Universitario de la Costa en el marco del 14º Festival Internacional de Cine en Puerto Vallarta agradecen su presencia. Muy buen día, estimado miembro del Presidium, directivos, profesores, alumnos y público que nos acompaña. Para dar inicio a esta clase magistral, me permito presentar a las personalidades que nos acompañan. Recibamos, por favor, al profesor e investigador de la University College Cork de Irlanda, Daniel O'Connell. Con la representación del doctor Marco Antonio Cortés Guardado, rector de este centro universitario, agradecemos la presencia del doctor Jorge Ignacio Chaboya Gama, director de la División de Ingenierías. Agradecemos la presencia de James Mulligan, director creativo del Festival de Cine de Cork. Gracias a todos por acompañarnos. A continuación, solicito al doctor Jorge Ignacio Chaboya que nos dirija las palabras de bienvenida.
Muchas gracias. Buenos días a todos y qué bueno. Están aquí todos reunidos en este marco tan importante del Festival Internacional de Cine de Puerto Vallarta. A nombre del rector de este centro universitario, el doctor Marco Cortés Guardado, que me honro en dar la bienvenida en esta ocasión para esta clase magistral de Digital Sensors, Effect of Independent Film Short Film, que va a impartir bien nuestro invitado de hoy, Daniel O'Connell, a quien le damos una calurosa recepción. You're welcome, Daniel. If this is your house, feel good, please. Con esto y sin mayor preámbulo, en este marco, yo les invito a todos ustedes que aprovechen esta plática magistral. Esta Universidad de Guadalajara, que es una universidad pública, que se caracteriza precisamente por hacer fuertes los vínculos de extensión, los vínculos de esta tan importante área del conocimiento que es precisamente los short films, que son los cortos, la digitalización, todos los consejos que de aquí puedan ustedes aprovechar, aprovechenlos. Nuestro rector se ha esforzado mucho en que cada vez la calidad académica investigación y de extensión sean el cuerpo de esta universidad y por lo tanto que sean precisamente el ámbito en el que se desarrollan todos ustedes como jóvenes universitarios. Bien, sin más preámbulo, demos la bienvenida a James Mulligan. Thanks for staying here. Daniel O'Connell, okay? Start, please. Muchas gracias a todos.
Hola, my name is Dan O'Connell. I'm from Cork in Ireland, and I'm a digital filmmaker, primarily. I also teach filmmaking at University College Cork. And I spent a long time thinking about what it was I was going to cover for this lecture today. And I wanted to bring a perspective of Irish cinema to Mexico.
Aquí lo que dice Daniel es que él lo que quiso traer es el cine irlandés para ustedes, para que lo entiendan y cómo él hace su trabajo y lo que a él le apasiona.
So when I say digital cinema, the digital cinema revolution, what do I mean by digital cinema? Well, basically any film that was shot with a digital camera, edited on a computer digitally, and then project it digitally in cinema.
El cinema digital, perdón, él quiere decir con eso todo lo que se toma con una cámara digital y lo que se proyecta digitalmente y se edita digitalmente.
So there's no film involved in this type of filmmaking, which is funny, because the title is filmmaking, but there's no film involved anymore, so.
Dice que aquí las grabaciones ya no tienen mucho que ver porque todo se hace por computadora.
Okay, so the digital cinema revolution. When I say revolution, it's a strong word. But if we bear in mind that only 16 years ago, it really didn't exist, digital cinema. And even at that, it was very experimental at the time. So there was, if you think back to the year 2000, there was only 15 cinemas in the world that could project digitally. And it really wasn't until 2006, just about 8 years ago, when digital cinema started becoming more mainstream across the world.
La revolución para él es una palabra muy fuerte. Cuando piensas de que empezó apenas hace 16 años con solo 15 cinemas que usaban este tipo de grabaciones, perdón. No fue hasta 2006, que fue hace 8 años, que fue cuando ya todos empezaron y comenzaron a usarlo.
So, Quentin Tarantino said, "I can't stand digital filmmaking, it's TV in public." So, whether he likes it or whether he doesn't like it, the use of 35mm print projection was expected to cease in the US by the end of 2013, and a global cutoff is likely to happen by the end of 2015. But in Ireland, virtually all cinemas now project digitally.
El uso de una proyección de 35 milímetros en los Estados Unidos se suponía que debería de haber estado en uso para el final del 2013 y de ahí haber arrancado totalmente hasta el 2015. Pero en Irlanda ya todas las cinemas usan el cinema digital.
So, in order to talk about the digital cinema revolution, I guess we should talk a little bit about digital cameras, because it's really the digital camera and how it has evolved over the last few years that has shaped digital cinema. So, the biggest turning point of digital cinema is the digital camera. They're so cheap, they're so accessible, they're so efficient compared to film.
Aquí lo que más se usa es la cámara digital, y él lo que quiere ver y enseñarles es el uso de la cámara digital dentro de lo que él hace.
So how does a digital camera differ from a film camera? Firstly, a film camera used film stock to record an image. It was a very linear method of recording light. Light would hit the film and you would have an analog signal, whereas digital uses a defined number of pixels to create an image.
La cámara digital diferencia de la cámara normal de video porque usa píxeles y muchas cosas que para hacer una imagen. No tomar la imagen.
So the digital sensor, usually a CCD sensor or a CMOS sensor, has really opened up the whole world of digital media. And so as these sensors evolve and get bigger and better, then the cinematography gets bigger and better in these films.
El sensor que usa la cámara digital es lo que hace casi todo el trabajo de una cámara digital. Dentro de esto, mientras el sensor sea mejor, mejor es la foto o la imagen que quiere producir.
So a digital sensor takes an analog signal, so like light, and it turns it into a digital signal with ones and zeros.
Un sensor digital toma una señal análoga y la convierte en
digits.
en dígitos para así crear la imagen.
So because digital sensors have a defined number of pixels, then analog shapes and analog light signals, they get turned into squares on the sensor, and the lower the resolution of the sensor, the more squares you see on the sensor.
Esta foto se convierte en cuadritos, como pueden ver aquí, y dentro de esos cuadritos se va formando la imagen. Entre menor calidad tengan los sensores, más cuadritos van a ver en la imagen.
So, resolution is the amount of pixels that the camera uses to create the image. If you think of it in terms of Lego, so if you had Lego blocks and you wanted to create the image of the Mona Lisa using Lego blocks, there's two restrictions. And the first restriction is the amount of Lego blocks you have, and the second restriction is the amount of colors you have to recreate the colors in the image.
Aquí él está comparando la resolución con bloques de Lego. Entre más bloques tengas, más cuadritos aparecen, y de ahí se van usando los colores para hacer la imagen.
So the more color you have, the more definition you have, and the more pixels you have, the more definition you have. And before you know it, these sensors now are so good, they can pick up a lot more of this resolution and color that the human eye can. And they can pick up really minute details such as the cracks in the Mona Lisa, the brush strokes.
Aquí con estos sensores ya se pueden identificar más cosas dentro, por decir aquí la Mona Lisa. Ya se pueden ver las brochas, o sea, los brochazos que daban mientras lo pintaban, y así ver más que lo que puede ver sus ojos.
This variance in color is also known as dynamic range.
El color varía y se llama dynamic range. Y perdón si no sé los términos.
So, in the early days of digital cinema, technical issues. So, in the early days of digital cinema, it was largely experimental, and the aesthetic of these films could never compete with film. They just did not look like film at all, and these films did not try to compete with that, but they used the digital as the aesthetic they were trying to convey. And it was the Dogma films by Lars von Trier in the late 90s was one of the first ever digital films that went into cinemas.
Cuando comenzaron a usar la cinema digital, cinema normal no podía competir con eso. Entonces, en 1998 fue cuando Dogma Film usó la primer película digital.
So, one of the first mainstream films then that came out was 28 Days Later, and that went on to become very successful in the cinema. And they used mini DV cameras, consumer cameras that you would use for like wedding videos and things like that, to make a film of it. And they used it deliberately because they wanted to convey a sense of voyeurism or newsreel footage, because they wanted the footage to feel like you were looking at it through a security camera. And that was 28 Days Later by Danny Boyle.
Aquí Danny Boyle usó cámaras normales para dar una imagen de que en realidad estabas viendo por una cámara de seguridad, pero en realidad no estabas viendo por una cámara de seguridad, se estaba usando el cinema digital.
So here's a sample of what those cameras did in that film. The aesthetic of that film is very lack of quality. It looks voyeuristic, like we're spying on that world. So you can see the lack of definition in that footage. It was a really very start of the digital revolution, so the cameras couldn't compete with, you know, the aesthetic of film in any way, shape, or form. But the next film to be made tried to compete deliberately with film.
Como pueden ver en el video anterior, se ve que no hay mucha calidad del video. Esta fue el primer video que se quiso hacer tratando de competir con la cámara digital. Pero como pueden ver, el color y todo no es de muy buena calidad.
So the first film to try to compete with film was Once Upon a Time in Mexico by Robert Rodriguez. So let's have a look at how the aesthetic had changed because the cameras had got better. So you can see the quality of the resolution got a lot better, but it still wasn't quite there yet. It still was a bit too sharp, and the aesthetic just wasn't right yet. So the cameras were being developed, they were getting better and better, but this was the very first one. It was developed for the Star Wars films by Lucas and Sony. They got together and made this camera. So it didn't really catch on in the film world. It was a couple of years before digital cinema became more mainstream. And some of the reason for that is the size, the actual dimension of the sensor.
Como vieron en el video anterior, la calidad sí mejoró un poco, pero aún no llegaba a lo que era la cámara digital, lo que podía ser en verdad, porque todavía se veían colores muy opacos o la calidad en sí del video no era de la mejor.
So the bigger the sensor, the more depth of field you have in the image itself. So it becomes more filmic looking, it looks more aesthetically pleasing than it does for such small sensors that they have in these kind of HDD type cameras and stuff. So.
Entre más grande el sensor, más se ve la calidad de un video o una película. Aquí tiene los tipos de sensores. Y sus tamaños y cómo funciona y la calidad que da.
So eventually these sensors became the same dimension shape as film, and that changed everything. And now the modern cameras that they use today, they are almost virtually identical to a 35mm print, both in dynamic range and in resolution.
Las cámaras que hoy se usan están idénticas al video, o sea, y las cámaras que se usan en cinema.
So here's an example of one of the cameras, a showreel that the camera put out from just last year of the types of films that are being made now with the new digital Arri Alexa. So digital filmmaking has huge advantages. I mean, the aesthetic is correct now, so it can directly compete with film. But it's cheap, a lot cheaper than film. You can directly connect it to your computer. You can edit the same day. You can see the image quality you're getting directly from the camera.
Al hacer un video digitalmente es más barato. Puedes ser directamente a tu computadora, puedes ver directamente lo que tú estás grabando y ver la calidad de la imagen que estás grabando directamente. No tienes que esperar hasta que salga un video o ir a que te lo pasen o a tu computadora y de ahí esperar hasta que lo tengan, pues para que tú puedas trabajar. Y con el digital puedes trabajar directamente desde que comienza.
So that's one advantage of digital cinema. The other is digital distribution. So now As a filmmaker, an independent filmmaker, you can go and you can shoot your film now really cheap, and then you can edit it on your computer, your laptop, whatever, and then you can sell it online really independently, direct to the customer. So digital distribution has really dramatically changed independent filmmaking.
La distribución digital ha cambiado mucho a los que hacen videos independientemente, porque ya así directamente pueden pasar sus videos por si a internet o a sus clientes y no tienen que pasar por un proceso tan largo.
So that's digital cinema, a quick overview of the evolution of the digital camera. But next I want to talk about the Irish film industry. How the digital camera has affected the Irish film industry.
Ya vimos lo que es la cámara digital y cómo se funciona. Ahora él les va a enseñar lo que es el cinema irlandés.
So I'll give you a brief history of Irish cinema. But firstly, I should tell you a little bit about Ireland and itself. So Ireland is a Catholic country. We were occupied by the British in the 16th century. There was a lot of civil unrest in the country. And we finally got our independence in 1948. It became a republic.
Irlanda es un país católico que se hizo independiente en 1948. Pasaron por mucha guerra, pero al fin ganaron su independencia y fue clasificada como un país del tercer mundo hasta los años 80.
So Irish film dates back as far as 1910 in the silent era. And since then, it's been largely dominated by external filmmakers in Ireland, making films in Ireland, up until the late 70s.
El cinema irlandés comenzó en 1910, mayormente por otros directores que son fuera de Irlanda, que iban ahí a grabar sus películas y todas sus videos.
So I'll show you a couple of films from that era just to get you up to speed. So Irish people were generally portrayed as being farmers, people living in fields and little houses. We all spent our days fishing, didn't take life seriously. So these films were all made by external filmmakers, trying to portray Ireland in a certain way. So there was no voice coming directly from Ireland.
Todos los videos que pasaron son películas que fueron hechas por personas fuera de Irlanda que querían enseñar al mundo lo que era Irlanda, cómo eran su gente, cómo era estar ahí,
so it wasn't until the late 70s when Irish indigenous filmmakers started to tell their story from their perspective. And they were trying to kind of defunct that stereotype that had been set up. So they went the opposite way and they tried to portray Irish people as not being so nice.
No fue hasta los años 70 cuando la misma gente de Irlanda empezó a hacer videos para que el resto del mundo viera en realidad cómo eran las personas de ahí, no como lo habían dicho en películas anteriores o como lo habían mostrado.
So these films were largely made in the Irish language and the main protagonist was usually a very unlikable character.
Muchos de sus videos fueron hechos en la lengua de Irlanda y por lo normal el protagonista no era alguien que a las personas les gustaba ver, un villano, por decir.
So these films were made for Irish people, by Irish people, and they weren't meant to be seen outside of Ireland, really. But it wasn't until the late 80s when a new wave of Irish filmmakers started making films that would appeal to a global audience.
Estos videos fueron hechos para la gente de Irlanda por la gente de Irlanda. La verdad, no querían que salieran del país, no eran hechos para que fueran vistos fuera del país. Y aquí podrían ver cómo era en realidad la gente de ahí.
So here are a few samples of those types of films. So that film was made by Jim Sheridan, who was here earlier this week. Did anyone here get to see him?
Yeah.
He's a legendary Irish filmmaker, and he's done some fantastic things for Irish film.
Este video fue hecho por Jim Sherry. Como ustedes ven, es alguien muy conocido de Irlanda, y él fue el que hizo ese video.
So, I've got some more to show you. So, you can see a lot of Irish filmmakers were trying to depict the class divisions, and this was about a family unit, you know, living in working class environment.
Aquí se ve cómo era la familia de media clase, porque son una familia que trabaja, y ahí quieren que vean cómo la familia es en Irlanda.
So the next one is slightly more modern, and it's actually a trailer, but it's for a film called The Wind That Shakes Barry. And it's a film that depicts Ireland's history, because in the late 90s, the film board was formed as a result of these new wave filmmakers. The government got behind Irish film in a big way, and they set up a board called the Irish Film Board, which had a remit to tell Irish stories and depict Irish lifestyle. And they commissioned a lot of films after this time.
Después de este tiempo, el gobierno de Irlanda comenzó a meter mucho en lo que era el cinema. De ahí comenzó el Irish Film Board, y empezaron a comisionar muchas de las películas que se grababan dentro de Irlanda.
So here's The Wind That Shakes the Barry. So that was pre-digital Irish film. So you can see everything there from 1910 right up to 2006, which is where digital film started to come into play.
Todos los videos fueron de 1910 al 2006, que fueron la era pre-digital del cinema de Irlanda.
So in 2006, a small feature film was made in Ireland, and it was funded by the Irish Film Board for the amount of €130,000.
En 2006, una grabación fue hecha en Irlanda, fundada por el Irish Film Board por 130,000 euros.
So never before that had a film been funded for such a little amount in Ireland, because film is so expensive, and it was only one or two little features a year would come out of Ireland as a result of the film board funding.
Nunca antes había hecho una película o un video por una cantidad tan baja en Irlanda. Siempre era muy costoso, y muy pocas veces eran las veces que salían videos o salían alguna película.
So this micro budget film was a kind of an experiment in digital, to see if you know digital film would be profitable and what you could achieve on such a small budget.
Este video es lo que enseña que todo lo que se pudo hacer con una cantidad tan chica de dinero.
So the film was called Once, and it was made for 130,000 euros, but made $20 million back in the box office, and went on to win an Oscar for Best Original Score.
La película se llamaba Once. Gastaron 130 mil euros para hacerla y ganaron 20 millones de euros en carteles, y también fue a ganar un Oscar por Best Original Song.
So this just demonstrates what's achievable if one has a good story to tell. This film was shot on HDV cameras, which were cheap cameras. So if you're a techno geek or a film lover, you have to take digital filmmaking seriously.
Si te gusta mucho la tecnología, esto fue un salto muy grande para las grabaciones y el cinema dentro de la era digital.
So that film was really successful, and the Irish Film Board took it very seriously. So they started a new scheme called the Catalyst Project, which would take small independent filmmakers, people who had no previous knowledge making big feature films or anything like that, and they would bring them together in a mentorship program and give them 250,000 euros then to make film. And that was successful, so they bought it back in last year. So the amount of digital films coming out of Ireland has gone very high.
The Catalyst Project es un proyecto por parte del Irish Film Board que tomaba a todos los productores booking de Irlanda que eran chicos, no muy conocidos, y los metía para que les daba 250 mil euros para que ellos pudieran hacer su película y así darse a conocer.
So that's a quick rundown of how digital cinema has benefited Irish film.
Eso es como el cinema digital ha ayudado mucho al cine irlandés.
So you can see in the numbers, between 1910 and 2006, there was 340 films, feature films, came out of Ireland. And since 2006, there's 450 films. So there's a big difference between, since digital came in, the amount of films that are coming out of Ireland.
Aquí pueden ver cómo en 96 años, de 1910 al 2006, salieron 340 películas. Y del 2006 al 2013, perdón, en solo 7 años salieron 450 películas.
So that's great for Irish film. But I really personally want to talk about local short films, unfunded films. We can understand now how digital cinema has affected the world scale and the Irish scale.
Lo que él se quiere enfocar más ahorita es hablar de las grabaciones short film, que no son muy conocidas, no son muy reconocidas, y como ya vieron lo que es el cinema digital para el mundo y para Irlanda, ahora quiere enseñarles lo que es para las ciudades locales.
Now, obviously, there's a lot you can talk about Irish film for a lot longer than that. It's just a brief synopsis. So I want to talk to you today about independent filmmaking communities.
Aquí él les quiere hablar de las comunidades independientes que hay dentro de Irlanda, que no son conocidas y son muy pequeñas ahora.
So you may have gathered that I'm from Ireland, but I'm also from Cork, which is a small city in Ireland.
como ya se dieron cuenta, él es irlandés, pero es de una ciudad llamada Cork, que es muy pequeña.
So it's a very small city, but it's got no film infrastructure. So no professional big budget films are generally made in Cork.
El cinema es muy reconocido ahí, pero dentro de Cork, pero aún no llega al cinema más grande, más conocido. No, ninguna producción ha salido de ahí ni ha sido filmada ahí.
If a big film was made in Cork, then the crew from that film would be picked from Dublin, which is the city, the capital city of Ireland.
Si alguna película fuera filmada en Cork, todas las personas que hicieron esa película, que estuvieran dentro de esa película, fueran de Dublin, que es la ciudad capital de Irlanda.
So before digital cameras, what was happening in the local scene in Cork? Well, not very much, very, very little. There was a few, one or two filmmakers who were seeking funding from the film board to make films, but generally, very, very few productions would come out of Cork.
Antes de la cámara digital, muy pocas producciones salían de Cork. Solo había uno o dos personas que se dedicaban a hacer videos o a hacer películas.
So, how did I get into digital filmmaking? So, I first started making films back in 2005. I had a small little camcorder, digital camcorder, and I used to use my nieces and my nephews, and my cousins, to star in my films, very amateur films.
Él comenzó a hacer videos en 2005 con su familia, sus primos, familia y amigos, con una cámara muy chiquita, muy pequeña, digital.
So I wanted to take it to the next level, and I wanted to be fellow filmmakers in the area, and I wanted to work with real actors.
Ya después él quiso subir de nivel y conocer personas que hacían lo mismo que él, dentro del área y también trabajar con actores de verdad.
So how do you go about doing that? There was no website, there was no information, there was no community in the area. I didn't know who else would be interested in helping out.
Como no había forma de comunicarse con esas personas, él no sabía cómo encontrarlas o cómo poder juntarse con ellas para hacer algo.
So I did a course in acting. There was a local course in acting for TV, and I attended the course. I didn't want to act, but I just wanted to meet some actors. And when I did, I took their names, I took their numbers, and I tried to keep in contact with them after the course.
Lo que hizo fue que él tomó un curso de actuación, pero él no quería actuar. Quería conocer actores. Cuando fue a su curso, tomó números de teléfono y nombres de algunas personas que conoció para seguir en contacto con ellos.
So I decided to build a website. So I built a little website called EgoMotion.
Después de ahí, él decidió hacer una página web llamada EgoMotion para comunicarse con las personas que quería conocer.
So we did a flyer, or I did a flyer, and handed it out at a local audition, and tried to get other filmmakers to log on to this website to become members of this forum.
Él hizo un cartelón como para promover su página web a los actores que había dentro de la región, para así que todos se conocieran.
So, EgoMotion was set up as an online filmmaking community in Cork, and we had a discussion forum, a writing corner, a database of actors, and a screening room for people who wanted to screen their films to other filmmakers.
Dentro de la página web había varias opciones para comunicarte con otros actores, al igual compartir tus videos con otras personas.
So it was a local online forum. And before we knew it, we had 100 members log on after the first week of the launch.
A la semana de comenzar con la página web, ya tenían 100 miembros dentro de la comunidad de la página.
So you can imagine how excited I was to meet other filmmakers. But I didn't want to just chat with them online, I wanted to meet them face to face. So we held a meet and greet night in Cork.
Tuvieron una meet and greet night para que todos se pudieran conocer frente a frente, no solamente chatear por internet.
So those virtual relationships became real relationships and collaborations came out of that.
Dentro de esas relaciones virtuales se hicieron relaciones reales y de ahí pudieron hacer más dentro de su comunidad local.
So, following on from that, we started to make films together. So we started to help each other out, teach each other. So it was a great way to learn how to make film.
Así ellos se fueron enseñando entre ellos mismos para grabar y compartiendo ideas para hacer cosas mejor o hacer las cosas diferentes.
So the next logical thing to do was to screen our films to an audience to show people our films or work. So we organized local screenings.
Después de que comenzaron a trabajar juntos, ellos empezaron a proyectar sus videos para que toda la demás gente pudiera ver lo que ellos estaban haciendo, en lo que ellos estaban trabajando.
And it was great because other filmmakers would hear about these and then come along and meet other filmmakers, and the forum grew as a result.
De ahí, otras personas que también hacían grabaciones comenzaron a conocer a las personas de Cork, ya sea ahí localmente o fuera del área.
So we started in a small pub in Cork, and there wasn't enough seats. The demand was very good.
La primera vez que hicieron una proyección de uno de sus videos, faltaron sillas. Entonces les fue muy bien en su primera proyección.
So we moved to bigger venues, and we had more crowds coming. So it was very popular. Our screenings were very popular.
De ahí se comenzaron a mover a auditorios más grandes, donde venía más gente, y así se fueron haciendo muy populares sus videos.
And because of that feedback, people were motivated to make more films. So there was more and more local short films being made in the area.
Y de eso comenzaron a hacer todavía más videos. Más gente salía y decía, no, pues yo quiero mostrar mi video. Y así, poco a poco, todos se empezaron a juntar.
So one of the main benefits of having a local, independent filmmaking community is that you can make films that deal with local causes, local issues, and you can help other organizations tell their story.
Lo bueno de ser local es que pueden ayudar localmente y a la gente de su localidad para así, por videos y por grabaciones, por películas cortas, poder hacer un cambio si se necesitaba.
So an example of this is when Ego Motion, a group of us filmmakers in Cork, got involved in a flash mob in Cork City. So rather than try to tell you the story, I will show you a clip.
Aquí es donde ellos empezaron a involucrar para hacer cambios dentro de Cork, con el gobierno, y les va a enseñar un video en vez de contar.
So there, that was actually a 20 minutes documentary that was made about it, and we were able to upload that on the internet and get feedback, and more people were able to see it online, and you know, were able to give feedback on, and you saw that in the video, the feedback actually on the video. So that was a good thing for Cork filmmakers to be able to get involved with.
Como pueden ver en el video, fue un éxito para ellos y para la comunidad de Cork, y para que ellos así poder siguiendo hacer lo que ellos querían, lo que ellos les gustaba.
So as the years went on, and people got better and better at making these films, these amateur filmmakers got better and better, and they started to go into career as a result. So the film community in Cork now has blossomed, and there's, you know, people from all different backgrounds making films, and it's fantastic. It really is a hotbed of short film.
Cuando pasaron los años, ya las personas que empezaron como grabadores pequeños se fueron desarrollando y así tomando sus carreras como haciendo lo que les gustaba.
For example, the first independent film studio was set up in Cork in 2012. It's a small film studio, but it's a start.
Ese fue el primer estudio que fue fue fundado en Cork, que fue en el 2012.
And in the same year, a new post production studio was set up by a local filmmaker.
Otro estudio también fue fundado en el mismo año.
Other filmmakers have gone on to become DOPs and professional videographers.
Ya muchos de los que estaban ahí como pequeños ahora son profesionales y trabajan profesionalmente como DOPs.
So, I owe my career to independent filmmaking, and I set up a production company 2 years ago. And just to give you an example of the kind of stuff that I've been working on the last couple of years, I'm going to show you a small snippet on my short work.
Les va a mostrar unos videos de lo que él ha estado trabajando los últimos años.
Local film festivals. I want to talk to you a little bit about local film festivals. James is probably here, and he'll probably give you a few tips about how to get into Cork Film Festival. But Cork Film Festival is an amazing film festival, and it has been around for a very long time. It's one of Europe's oldest film festivals. And, you know, people of Cork love film, and that helps local filmmakers.
El Festival de Cork es, ha estado por muchos años, y es muy famoso, ya que la gente de Cork le gusta mucho conocer a los nuevos talentos que hay dentro de Cork y fuera de Cork.
So Cork Film Festival has always been an aspiration for a local filmmaker to get their film into Cork Film Festival. And the program for Cork Film Festival, Cork Local Shorts, has grown and grown over the years and has become a very, very popular program, as James will probably tell you, in the film festival, which is great. And it gives filmmakers a goal to achieve.
De aquí pueden ver que hay un programa que ayuda a los grabadores pequeños para que se puedan meter al producto en Facebook y así proyectar sus trabajos.
Okay, so over the years, because of the amount of films coming out of Cork now, and the festivals have grown as well, and now there are lots of new film festivals popping up in the city. And all of them are very, very popular. I mean, it's incredible that there's 6 film festivals in Cork, and all of them get bums on seats. It's fantastic.
Después de la Cork Film Festival, surgieron más film festivals. Ahora hay 6, y todas son muy populares. Todas se llenan dentro de la misma ciudad.
Along with these festivals, there's festivals for young people now as well. So for people in secondary schools, they can now make films and compete.
También hay programas para personas más chicas que proceden en la secundaria o preparatoria que también pueden mostrar sus trabajos dentro de la film festival.
So local education has really improved in the last few years as well, and there's a lot more courses being offered in Cork now as a result of the interest in filmmaking that has popped up over the years.
La educación local ha mejorado mucho. Ya hay más programas que se enfocan en ayudarle a las personas que les interesa trabajar en esto para que así realicen sus sueños.
So the newest of these courses is the one that I teach. It's the BA in Film and Screen Media at UCC.
Él es maestro de uno de nuestros cursos que ayuda a los jóvenes. Es el BA Film and Screen Media. Ese es el curso que él enseña.
Okay, so I'd like to show you a little bit about that course now as well. So for anyone here interested in coming to Cork, that's what it's like. We have lots of fun. So that film was made by a good friend of mine, and it went on to be very successful in different festivals around the world. And it was made through digital media, and there was no money involved. And if it wasn't for digital cameras and digital filmmaking, then that film would never have got made, along with so many other local Cork films that went on to become very successful. So, before I finish up, one last thing, I want to open the floor for maybe a question or two. So, anyone have a question?
Si gustaría preguntar algo.
Hello, good afternoon. My name is Jesus, Mr. Daniel. And so what I want to ask is, what are all those facilities that we can have for all these students interested in going to participate in some of the activities at University College of Cork?
So you want to know what happens if you come to Cork University?
Yeah, or if you've been like creating some kind of opportunity straight like from this university, or if there's any program.
Well, we're currently working on trying to bring something together, but not nothing is in concrete yet.
Okay.
Well, first of all, congratulations, because I really liked it. And well, where do you get your inspiration from? That's my question.
Inspiration. Well, what I tell my students about inspiration is to watch everything around you and always have something to hand that you can take something down if something comes to you just there and then, and become a kind of bit of a peeping Tom, you know? Watch other people, watch what other people are doing. And when you're on the bus, you know, listen to other people's conversations. Don't let them know that you're listening, but listen to other people's conversations and see what you can come up with from there. And sometimes, like, setting restrictions for yourself too can open up a whole world of creativity. So that's what I tell my students. Thank you.
How can you difference between a movie that's made of digital filming and 35mm? Because when you go to the movies, you don't see the big difference.
That's the whole point. I mean, the whole point is that the digital cameras from years back, you could totally tell that they were digital. And the film was so much more beautiful to look at. But now the new digital cameras, they have, I mean, nearly every film that you go to see now is shot on a digital camera. But you can't tell. And that's the whole point, is that the aesthetic has improved so much now. And even really small cameras, like you could buy a DSLR camera, would have a big sensor, and you could shoot a film on a DSLR camera for under €1,000. I don't know how much that is in pesos, but you can buy a camera for really cheap, and you can make a film that looks just as good as 35mm film. So that's the whole point of the revolution.
Not to tell the difference.
Yeah, to be able to not tell the difference, yeah. So people go see a film, they don't think, was the shot digital or was the shot film? It doesn't matter.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay, so,
Hi, I have a question regarding lines of distribution over in Ireland. I mean, your students, when they work on film, digital film, what process do they go for when it comes to distributing the film to other countries or within Ireland?
Well, with short film, short digital films, which is what they do, then the best means of distributing the film is film festivals. So uploading your video to Vimeo and submitting it to as many festivals as you can for free, and then strategically pick the festivals that you think that your film might get into. So identify something. So if you can identify something in your film that would appeal to a festival, then submit to that festival. And just, you know, be strategic in how you submit those films to festivals. But generally, once it does the festival runs, you want as many people as you can to see it, so up online, tweet, Facebook, all that. Yeah, okay. So, just one last thing. Has digital media ruined the film industry? There's a bit of a debate going on at the moment. Manola Dargis from the New York Times thinks it is. And a lot of other big producers in Hollywood think that digital film is dangerous and there's too many films coming out. But, you know, that is true. There is an awful lot of films coming out. And, you know, the whole film industry is awash films. It's very hard to choose which one to watch. But cream always floats to the top. And with that, a rising tide floats all boats. So if some local filmmaker here in the audience wants to make a film, don't let anything stop you from making the film. And if you are successful, then the people around you will also become successful. So just don't let anything stop you from making the film. And if it wasn't for digital media, I'm going to bring you back to another film just before we wrap up. We'd never have seen this scene from this film. So thank you very much, and we'll see you again.
Del profesor de la Universidad de Cork, Daniel O'Connell, e invito al doctor Jorge Ignacio Chaboya Gama, director de la División de Ingenierías de este centro universitario, quien nos hará el favor de entregar el reconocimiento con la representación del doctor Marco Antonio Cortés Guardado, rector de este centro, que me permito leer la constancia a Daniel O'Connell por su participación como conferencista en la clase magistral de Digital Censors Effect on Independent Irish Short Film en el marco del Festival Internacional de Cine en Puerto Vallarta, llevado a cabo el día de hoy, 31 de marzo de 2014. Agradece su participación en esta actividad dentro del marco del 14º Festival Internacional de Cine de Guadalajara. Muy buenas tardes y gracias por su presencia.